Hey everybody, this is Captain Kinetic, and today I want to share with you three slide transformation that I personally did for a new friend of mine. He owns a real estate company in the US. So let's begin with the first one. Share screen. So a typical slide that we receive at Kinetic Slides has slides that do not use the brand color. So the brand from this logo, you can see that the brand colors are gray and orange. And this friend of mine, he has a red, green, an aqua, and a navy. And these colors are, you know, putting a lot of colors on your slide is a no-no to creating a premium looking pitch deck, right? Next rookie mistake that I see here is the ineffective use of space. Why? Because this these icons are way bigger than the content, which we want to communicate, right? We want to communicate the content more than the graphics. So a third one is the visual hierarchy, because there are tons of things that you see on the screen. It's kind of difficult for you to focus on one thing at a time. So try to, as much as possible, work with layout, size and colors to incite visual hierarchy so that, you know, your audience would know where to look at first, second, and third. Last rookie mistake that I see here is the contrast. So it's difficult for you to read these texts because the background is a bit, mucky. I don't know. But yeah, let's take a look at the transform slide. Again, go back to the previous one, this, and then this. So what are my initiatives in transforming this into something that looks $1 million? If not $1 million, then at least something that looks professional, right? First one is to remove all the colors that are not consistent to the brand. So we don't have the red, the green, the aqua, and the navy. Next one is, I think I did justice to the space here. I made it a bit effective by focusing on the content rather than the icons. So you can see I also replaced the icons, right, with the of this ones and also here. Next one is the visual hierarchy. I formatted the similar data uniformly. For instance, this one, 328 and 150.1 billion, they have the same format compared to this one, that this one is bigger than this one. I think they are just on the same level of importance, right? So hierarchy. Last one is the contrast. So you can see that it's easily readable now compared to the previous one, right? Other initiatives that I did is to first convert the chart from looking like this into a 100% bar graph so that it consumes lesser space, right? Second is I kind of reworded some phrases like the annual new apartment demand. This one, it used to read as new apartments needed annually. So it's kind of long, right? I mean, not really, but yeah, you get what I mean. I mean, I think it reads better than the original one. Let's take a look, right? New apartments needed annually. So yeah, compared to 328,000, it is the annual new apartments demand, right? Third one initiative that I did is to switch left and right section to emphasize the main idea more. So I feel like this section deserves more attention compared to this. So I placed it on the left side of the slide. Lastly, I used consistent icon type. Like for instance, here on the left section, we have the line icons. And on the right section, you have the filled icons. So that's it for our first transformation. Next slide transformation is this slide. Rookie mistake number one is the contrast between the image and text. As you can see, it's not readable, right? Second one is the repetition of the text and the diagram. So what this means is that these four or six bullets are integrated as part of the solution of this company. So you don't really need this one. It's either you take this out or you take this out. You'll see later on what I did with the slide. Next one is too much colors too, with the use of this one, and this, right? Lastly, I think this logo is too big. It doesn't really add value to the slide. So this is what I did. First is that I remove the images for the diagram, and I replaced them with small icons instead. And also removed the bullets, this bullets, and just stick to this one to avoid the repetition, right? So anything that's not added on the list, I'm not sure if you noticed, but the construction and asset management is not part of the diagram. But what the speaker can do as an option is to just include those two bullets in the speaking point, right? Because I also researched about this company and found that this is really their kind of paradigm or framework of their solution. So I didn't add the two icons. Next one is too much colors. So what I did is to replace the colorful icons to line icons, this one's, for consistency, right? So the logo is too big. What I did was actually just get rid of it and then maintained this footer right here, which is is less distracting than the logo, right? Other initiatives that I did is to change the orientation of the diagram. As you can see, it's like a Venn diagram, right? So what I did is to just make sure that these labels are outside the image or the icon so that they stand out better. Another initiative is that I maintained the styling from the first slide transformation. So you can see that this slide also has a dark gray box in it and has a transparent image, which is kind of a similar look and feel as to this one, right? So gray box and then and a transparent image at the background. That's it. Last slide. I'm just going to talk about two rookie mistakes here. First one is the visual hierarchy. Again, it's very important because we wanted to communicate the first things first, second thing, and then third thing, right? We want the audience to kind of look here because this is the most important thing on this slide, and then look here because this is the additional information, and then look here because it's not that important as the first two, but you know, deserves to be there in case you wanted some more details, right? First is the visual hierarchy. Why? Because I don't know about you, but for me, I feel like these blue dots here are taking a lot of attention, right? Taking a lot of attention from the actual content. Second rookie mistake that I see here is that it looks a bit busy, I think because of the layout and the contrast. So here's what I did. So for the first issue, the visual hierarchy, what I did was to minimize the size of the dots, as you can see, right? To look less busy, what I did was to make this map a bit grayish compared to the black map, right? So I think this one, what we wanted to communicate here is that, hey, we have this network of opportunities in Dallas and lots of places, right? And I also did two initiatives here. The first one is to color the dots that represents the states where the company currently operates. So for instance, I don't know what states this is, right? But I know for sure that this is Texas. So as you can see, if I want to zoom in, Texas has, they operate 700 plus units in Texas. And so what I did was to color these dots to represent that, hey, we are present in this state. Also, I made the headquarter a bit more obvious. Zoom in that, hey, they are here in this state and this is the current opportunity in that state. That's it. And again, the styling here, it has this box with an image that is transparent. So you can still see and read all these posts right here. So those are the three transformations that I did, and I hope you like it and you learned something.